All right, welcome to the 2015 race number 8 of the Missouri Hare Scramble Championship Series. It's held at the Hardwood Hills Ranch, and it's located near Mansfield, Missouri. It's about, 45 minutes east of Springfield, Missouri. It's a great weather. However, the weather's been great for a while now, so not a lot of rain. It's a bit dusty, and right now I'm praying for a great start. Great start, so I can get that hole shot, because... well, the lack of rain makes things interesting. And rough. Decent start, not the best. That's Alejandro there on my right. Chris up in front of me. Chris got a good start. Alejandro's riding the Gas, 2014 model. Sharp looking bike. Gas 300. Here we are in this first section here. It's pretty rough here. This is one of the rougher sections in my mind. Right through here. It's just a lot of bumps in the trail. Get you kind of bouncing a bit. All the way up until you get to the road. That off-camber turn there is always giving me troubles. We had the Enduro here the previous weekend, and between then and now, we've only had one little rain on Friday. And it's pretty much all dried up. This is essentially loop one, with a few exceptions of the Enduro. Ah! Not a prime opportunity there, but an opportunity to try to make it past there by following. Few times where they zig, I need to zag. Prime example. There's not a whole lot of passing opportunities here. A lot of this kind of fast single track trail. However, there are a few exceptions. And here we are a few minutes later. I had a hope of trying to get around him. And right up here too, in this creek bottom. Kind of wanted to stay to the right here, so passing wasn't too likely. Or the left back there. Still chasing Chris. Alejandro's still right behind me. Excuse me. And this kind of just shows you the dusty trail. It's hard to see those rocks. And so I'm just kind of riding and praying a bit here. Dusty. So I was asked, is it as tight as it looks as far as the trees and whatnot? And I feel like it is. And I mean, obviously in some areas, like here, it's pretty tight through here. Shoulders might be rubbing a good some of these trees and whatnot. You definitely can't take a four-wheeler or a quad through a lot of this. Alright, zag when he's zigged. But yeah, I'd say it's as tight as it looks, as far as the trees go. It's definitely smoother. I said, well, I don't know about that, but I said it definitely smoothed it out a bunch. The other thing it does is make me look a lot faster than what I probably really am. Now here's a good hill. Pretty challenging to follow somebody else up a hill in my mind, because I'm always trying to find a way to get around him or look for an escape route if he has a problem, and then add to that the dust. I don't know, that might be sea rider problems. I'm not sure about you A and B guys if you're watching. Section up here probably had the most rollers, you know, loose couple inch size rocks back there going up that last section of hill climb. I've been closer. This was a long downhill. At least it felt like it. I get more worn out going downhill than I do going up a hard uphill. And then lots of rollers. And I don't remember this being on the Enduro. I could be wrong, but I just do not recall it. About the only mistake I really saw Chris make there. The whole time I was following him. Well, there was one on a hill. He's consistent though. He's very consistent. Oh, here's my zig and zagging. I knew about that log crossing. So I was thinking, oh, that could be an opportunity. So I've never really done it in parallel with somebody else, but it is not faster. Here about two thirds and oh, there's my first mistake of the race, really. Major mistake. And Alejandro's right on my tail right now. And then we get to this climb here. There's a bypass to that ruddy section right there to the left, and I realized it too late. Alejandro right behind me. Oop. Sorry. Thank you. So here we are. Chris is a few seconds ahead of me. Alejandro's right behind me, and that's kind of where he starts to separate himself from me, and therefore also Alejandro, because Alejandro's still behind me. Unfortunately, this is C class rider up here. You can still see Chris up there. Oh, no, that's not Chris, that's somebody else. But yeah, he started to separate on that hill and I never really caught up to him again. I didn't get around him. Oh, another example of zigging when they zag or whatever. Follow him. He would have let me pass there. Dang it. Fortunately, I still have Alejandro behind me and Chris is just getting further and further away. Oh, mess up. Could have tried to block him, but at this point, he has a better chance at catching Chris than I do, so I let him go. Ah, that dust. It's a good example. I kind of just lay off the gas here because I can't see the ground. There's a few rocks here and there. I just didn't want to hit the wrong one. Here's the big hill. If you race to, you know what I'm talking about. This is a good example where the GoPro smooths things out. This is rougher than a cob. And there's Alejandro. I caught up to him on this hill. The track. So I try to get on the grass a little bit and see, and by that time it's cleared up. Alright, so here we are coming in for the first lap. Alejandro ends up being 3 seconds ahead of me. Chris's belief is, 15 seconds ahead of me. And I'm still feeling pretty good. That's about a 40 minute lap for us. So at that point, I pretty much know that we'll only be doing 3 laps because I won't be going any faster. And it's a 2-hour race, but the 2-hour race starts when the front row starts, and we're about 10 minutes back from there. So really, it's about an hour and 50 minute race for us. Came to realize that Alejandro I can catch him on the uphills, but on the flat stuff or the downhills, he tends to start separating from me. Unfortunately, there's a lot more of the flat to downhill than there is to these uphills. Because you can see up here, Yep, there he is, after not being within view. But eventually I just start losing contact and pretty much trying to just race the clock now. I know there's other sea veteran riders behind me. I'm not sure where or who. And here's my first complete loss of momentum. Which for me is the longest I've ever made it into a race with that kind of consistency. By quite a bit, really. Yep. And here's the first people to actually pass me, too. So that's Rob, and that's Mike there in the second. They're C senior class racers. And they had quite a duel going on the entire race. They were never, well, at least through scoring, they were never more than 4 seconds apart. So I imagine it was pretty consistent that way throughout the whole race. That's some battling going on there. And then there was a third racer, not too far behind him, actually. All right, so not a whole lot fun, exciting stuff happening there. Oh, there's Billy Jack there in the blue. Unfortunately, in the last race, he hurt himself, but he's here working today. He's saying, well, last lap, you got it. Still in third in that lap. It was a minute 40 behind Alejandro and 2 minutes 31 seconds behind Chris. So Chris is getting on it. He actually had a very impressive race. Oh, here's me just getting worn out, riding like a huge baby. So I was looking at some statistics as far as, you know, race times go and how much I slow down and. With the winner of the race, with how they typically do and how the class winner does. And, you know, the race winner's in like 1%, 2%, maybe 3%, you know, fastest lap difference between their slowest lap. And class winner somewhere around 5. I'm usually somewhere in the teens. Chris today's only at 1%. He was right there with Alex Smith, the winner. His fastest and slowest was only a 1% difference. Here's me having some sympathy troubles here. Pretty sure that's what that was, why I'm getting stuck for no particular reason. But no, that's number 285 there. And he gives me something to chase after for a while, actually. Yeah, I was kept trying to chase him, and I'd catch up, and he'd somehow get ahead, and catch up again, and finally he lets me pass here. So I was like, shoot, I better get on it, because I don't want to be holding him up. Now here's what this looks like when I'm tired. Clearly not as hard charging as the first lap. Coming into the finish. Finished in 2 hours and 9 minutes. And had a good time. It was great, actually. Challenging, fun course, and fast. So yeah, I got third place. Thanks to everybody out at HHR. You guys did an amazing job. There was 5 racers. But yeah, I had a great time, and unfortunately, I won't be at the last race. However, I will be doing the hillbilly. I'll see you all there. Bye.